quick backstory muna. I started my interest in making internet videos back in 2016. My first camera was a Xiaomi Yi Action Cam. Then, nung 2017, nag-graduate na ako from college, my aunt gave me a graduation gift, which is ito, yung G7X Mark II.
Look what I've got here. A walking guitar.
Bye-bye, Sim.
Kapiran niyo naman si Sim. Ano ba yan, Francis?
Dog.
Bye-bye. Then by 2018, that's the time when I bought yung Canon M50, which is this one. And yun, currently it's my main camera na ginagamit ko for making these YouTube videos. So basically, I have two setups. First yung indoor and second yung outdoor. Pero pag-usapan muna natin yung indoor setup ko. So yung summary ng indoor setup ko is this. I'm using a Canon M50 body, then yung lens ko is a Canon EFM 22mm f2 na lens and Zoom H6 as my audio recorder. So bakit M50? So basically, ano lang ba yung kailangan mo when you're making a YouTube video? So una, para sa akin, you need a front-facing screen, you need something that has good autofocus, you need something na interchangeable lens for flexibility, you need a camera na pwede mo lagyan ng mic input, and can do 24 frames and simple slow-mo na may 60 frames per second. And if titignan mo M50, siya yung pinakamurang camera that has those essential needs ko. Now, let's talk about yung lens ko naman, which is yung Canon EFM 22mm f2. So, bakit siya yung gusto kong lens? Simple lang, it's fast and it's cheap. So, paano malalaman if fast yung lens mo? So, fast yung lens mo if yung aperture niya, yung f-stop niya, is 2.8 or lower. So, bakit gusto ko yun? Una, it's good for low light kasi it allows more light na pumasok sa kanya pag mababa yung f-stop niya. And if titignan mo yung background ko, it's blur. It allows you to have yung shallow depth of field and nagkakaroon ng bokeh pagka may mga ilaw-ilaw ka sa background mo. Lastly, para sa indoor setup ko, let's talk about yung audio recorder ko, which is my Zoom H6. Ito, hindi ko siya nire-recommend para sa lahat. I only recommend this if you intend to make a podcast na kailangan mo ng multiple mics. Because it is also an audio interface. So, ayun. So, before ito, ang ginagamit ko before is yung Boya by MM1 na mic. So, parang shotgun mic siya na maliit lang. So, parang siyang Rode Micro. Alam ko yun yung counterpart niya eh. Sa akin, mas prefer ko gamitin yun if nag-beginner ka pa lang compared to this Zoom H6. So, parang magiging sulit lang itong Zoom H6 if you intend to have a podcast kasi it also works as an audio interface and a mic. So, kung gusto mo na upgrade from a Boya Bi na mic or yung Rode Video Micro, I suggest kunin mo yung DT B mic, D3, basta lagay ko na dito sa screen. Hindi ko kabisado kung ano yung product ng DT na yon. Basta DT mics, or pwede din naman yung Rode Wireless Go if parang magalaw, gusto mo yung gumagalaw-galaw ka kasi para siyang lavalier mic. So, yun, that's all for my indoor setup, yung body, yung lens, and yung audio na ginagamit ko. Lastly, let's talk about my outdoor gear setup. So, para dito, simpleng-simple lang, I just bring two gears, which is yung G7X Mark II ko and yung DJI Spark ko sa likod. So, bakit yun lang? Kasi pagka outdoor ako, I love to parang experience yung bagay-bagay. Hindi lang ako nandun para to shoot yung or to capture yung content ko. So, yun, parang I prioritize experience more than anything, kaya yun lang. Yung G7X is enough to parang capture everything that I need. Pangit nga lang audio, pero I mean, it works. Then pagka gusto ko ng aerial footage, yung DJI Spark ko, it's enough. Hindi ko naman kailangan yung sobrang wow na mga aerial footage. So basically, yun lang. If you have comments and feedback, just leave sa comment section. And if you want to have a chat with me about gears, usap tayo sa comment section. That's it. Bye!